Fireworks are a symbol of celebration of our independence from British tyranny. With consumer fireworks reaching over $2 billion in revenue, it's no surprise we love shooting a bunch of them off at night. However, more statistics show thousands of adults and children in the U.S. injuring themselves by not using these pyrotechnics in the correct way. KTVO's Jordan Barr talked with the fire official and has tips on how to have a safe 4th of July.
Whether in the nation's capital or in your backyard, fireworks are quite the sight and sound. With whooshes and whistles, bangs and booms, they're just plain fun to watch. But if you plan to be the one helping to light them off, there's some things you need to keep in mind. First, have a way to extinguish a firework if it goes out of control and starts a fire.
We ask that you have a bucket of water relatively close by. A water hose works, a fire extinguisher can work for that as well. If one of those lights on fire, you can go ahead and extinguish that pretty quickly.
The same can be said for fireworks after they've been used. Those that are duds or with fuses that burn out should not be relit. You're liable to hurt yourself if the firework goes off with a short fuse. Give those a good soak to prevent them from igniting. Next, kids love those sparkler sticks, but as Kirksville Deputy Fire Chief Travis Gregory says, even those can be dangerous.
Keep in mind that those can burn up to 2,000 degrees Fahrenheit, so they're extremely hot. A lot of places don't recommend kids use sparklers at all. The responsibility is going to be on the parents to make sure that they're watching their children and making sure that they're being safe.
According to the U.S. Consumer Product Safety Commission, over 10,000 people were treated in emergency rooms for firework-related injuries in 2022. Of those, 11 people died. 38% of those injuries were burns to the face, hands, and other areas. Gregory also says don't tie fireworks together. Light them one at a time as directed by their instructions. Finally, we asked Deputy Chief Gregory about the response time of fire officials and what you can do to help before crews arrive. Within Kirksville, fire crews can make it to your location in about 5 minutes. As for what to do, he says everyone's level of first aid is different, but regardless, always call 911.
When you call dispatch, you want to make sure that you try to remain calm and give them the correct information, your correct address. If you're behind the home, you know, it would be handy for somebody to be able to meet us at the street to lead us to where you actually are.
So to recap, once you've used a firework, it's good to put it in a good dose of water, in a bucket, or from a hose to keep it from lighting again or sparking another fire. Fireworks with short fuses or any that don't light off when you light them, don't light them again. Some of the simplest fireworks you should be careful with, like these sparklers, some of the bottle rockets, or even these snappers. These are safe for kids, but you should still use common sense when playing with them anyway. Finally, if you have an emergency, don't panic. Just immediately call 911 and give the dispatcher as much information as you can so that the fire crews and paramedics can arrive at your home quickly. Do all of this, and you might just have a safe and happy 4th of July.